just took out a beautiful mass from the oven. So yummy and delicious. You must be here for the delicious entrees on your menu. I'm so glad. I would like to go over some of these delicious entrees with you and show you the beautiful buffet of all the deliciousness and freshness of every one of these ingredients. Let's see. Your first entree is mascarita pizza. Delicious! Create a mask using recycled materials and cardboard. Where do I begin? Well, cardboard. Good start. You could use round. You could use square. But look, one has nothing on it. One has many things on it. We call this collage. You collage your cardboard with paper. Or you paint with paint. Like this fresh, delicious mascarita pizza. From there, you can choose whatever you want. How about some delicious, colorful market caps? You could create a very texturized pizza with this. Something more delicate, perhaps. Some beautiful, delightful, shimmering bulbs. All of this is possible, but the things to remember about the mascarita pizza. Symmetry is each side is balanced with the same designs and patterns. Also, remember texture. This cardboard has texture. Look closely. Closer. You're not close enough. Come, you must smell it. Can you smell it now? Yes. You see the texture. You see the texture. That is what I'm talking about. That is mascarita pizza, yes? And now we go to mazzarella with meatballs. Ah, that's one of my favorites, as you can tell. Yes. Now, this one is create a two-dimensional media mask. I think I'm going to change this up a little bit. I noticed that some of you like the Day of the Dead, Venetian mask. Let me introduce you to a material that I call Plata a Paris. Fantastic stuff. You can get this beautiful 3D mask, but you don't get to keep. No, you must make your own, like this. And the way you do that is you take this delicious mozzarella cheese plaster Paris, and you're going to layer your mask. You layer nice and even. I'd say you need maybe 2 coats, and you do this so it's nice along the even. Don't get the edge. No, not necessary. You just want to smooth that out until you get something like this. Ah, it'll dry in 2-3 hours. It'll be hard as a rock, but light enough for you. You can even put it on your face. What can you do with this? It's endless. I don't even know. You into cyborg? Metal. Shiny metal, make them look like robot masks. You want it to be beautiful? You can take some beautiful fabric ribbon, glue this, wrap it around her, add some beautiful, delicious flowers, paint, you name it, it's yours. But remember, symmetry, balance, color, texture, all these things come into play when you are doing mazzarella and the meatballs. Okay, my last one, very fun entree. Mousse and mask burger. Cool. So fun. So, with this, you're going to be working with clay. You will get a slab of clay, and you're going to need a rolling pin. You roll it out. Not too thin, not too thick. Nice slab. You have choice. Keep it flat, do geometrical designs like so. Glaze. Beautiful, fire, nice and shiny. Or you could use this. Take your plastic mask and lightly drape this over so you have sort of a mask shape. And from there, you can add textures. One of my favorite things to add textures is using texture masks. Let me see if I can get some help in here. Hello? Anybody in the kitchen? Ah, yeah, Gracias. You roll a texture mat onto the clay. You press it very hard. You get beautiful texture. And from there, you can move it on, leave it flat, or you put it on to the face. And from there, you can now begin to design and add things. But instead of using hot glue, what you do with the other entrees, you're going to use very specific clay techniques. We have what we call scoring. And you will have scoring tools. And you will need slurry. Slurry is like the glue of clay. There you go. Look at this, scoring tool. Say I want to do a mask that looks like spring. I'm going to cut out some leaves. I'm going to add some detail to my leaves, like so. I'm going to score my piece. I add little hash marks on the front and on the back of each piece that I glue on. A little bit of water on both sides, and you glue it down. You can even shape it to make it look like it's popping off. And you continually do that on anything that you add to your clay. Key thing when working with clay, not too thin. Too thin, it breaks off. Gone. Nothing I can do about it. You put it in the oven, very hot oven. Clay needs to be strong and stable. So think about that. If you are going to do mousse and mask burger, you come out with beautiful clay. So, what did we learn from all of this beautiful buffet? You take a little bit of this, a little bit of that, you stir it around, and you get a wonderful mask. But you must think to yourself, which entree is going to serve my mask design the best? Is it one that I create with using recycled materials? Is it one that I create plaster of Paris mask? Or is it the clay? These are the things that you need to discuss with your fantastic art teacher. What's your name? What's your name? Miss W. Yes. Talk to Miss W. She will help you with all of this stuff and have a fun time in this artistic and outrageous restaurant. Ciao.